In a natural landscape, much of the ground is permeable, meaning water can filter down into the ground. When it rains on a natural landscape, the water can pass through the soil and reach underground aquifers. The ground acts as a filter, cleaning out pollution that water may pick up on its journey from the clouds. Building roofs, driveways, vehicles, and compacted soil are impervious surfaces. They prevent water from penetrating into the ground. Instead, it builds up and runs off, collecting pollution like bacteria and excess nutrients as it goes. This is called stormwater pollution. According to the EPA, stormwater pollution is the greatest threat to our nation's surface waters. This polluted runoff may flow directly into local streams and ditches, or down driveways and streets and into storm drains. Water that enters storm drains in South Carolina is not treated. Polluted water in local ditches, streams, or storm drains will eventually flow into larger rivers. That water eventually flows into the Atlantic Ocean, carrying any pollutants it picked up along the way. Our actions at home can have long-lasting impacts for us and our neighbors that live downstream. One way you can make a difference and help keep South Carolina's waters clean is by reducing the amount of runoff that comes from your property. A rain barrel like the one you'll make today can collect up to 50 gallons of water at a time to be used around your property for chores like watering gardens or houseplants, or washing your car or garden tools. An empty rain barrel is a useful rain barrel. Full rain barrels cannot collect more water. Make sure you use it.
Thanks for doing your part to protect water quality by building a rain barrel for your home landscape. This is what a completed rain barrel looks like. Let's take a closer look at some of the different parts. At the top, there's an opening to collect rainwater. There's a protective screen attached with a bungee to keep debris out of the rain barrel. On one side, there's an overflow hose. If your rain barrel fills up during a rain event, the overflow allows extra water to be redirected to a planted area or even a second rain barrel. At the bottom is a hose bib. This allows you to control the flow of water out of the rain barrel. You can use this to fill up a watering can or bucket or attach a hose. Remember that your water pressure is dependent on only gravity, so you won't get a lot of pressure out of a hose unless you install a pump in your rain barrel. Let's take a look at the steps that we've already taken to get your rain barrel started. We cut off the top of the barrel with a jigsaw and a blade designed for plexiglass. We left the outer rim intact so that you can attach a protective screen using a bungee cord later. We drilled holes for the hose bib and overflow hose. We used a rasp to make sure each hole was the appropriate size for the fittings. If you know that you want to paint your rain barrel, it may be easier to do that before following the rest of the steps in this video, so we'll go over painting now. If you decide that you want to paint your barrel after installing all of the hardware, you can just tape over anything you don't want to get paint on. Painting your rain barrel can add some creativity and aesthetic value, but it can also serve another purpose. The paint will block some sunlight, which can help to slow or stop the growth of algae in your rain barrel. You'll want to start by cleaning the outside of your barrel thoroughly. We used a 1:1 water and vinegar solution here. You can also lightly sand the outside of the barrel to help your paint stick. Tape paper or cardboard over any holes from the inside of the barrel to block any paint from getting inside. We recommend using a spray-on primer as a base layer. Make sure the spray paint is intended for use on plastic and for outdoor use. People sometimes use acrylic paint to paint on details, and this will likely hold up fine. Here we're using a latex paint that is intended for outdoor use. Finally, protect your artwork with a clear coat that is UV resistant so it won't yellow over time. Here are some examples of painted rain barrels. If you don't have much artistic ability, don't let that stop you. You can get creative in other ways, like using stencils or things you find in nature to create fun patterns. Okay, let's get to building our rain barrel. Parts you will need include a PVC adapter, conduit lock nut, hose clamp, and hose for your overflow. A PVC bushing, a conduit lock nut, a hose bib, and thread tape for your hose bib. A piece of screen and bungee for the top of your barrel. And silicone and a glove to seal around fittings. The only tools you'll need are a flathead screwdriver and a wrench. Start by applying thread tape to the straight end of your hose bib. Screw your hose bib into the large PVC bushing and screw the bushing into the large hole at the bottom of your rain barrel. Screw your smaller PVC adapter into the overflow hole at the top of your rain barrel. Screw the conduit lock nuts on the PVC fittings inside the barrel. It's helpful to have a long wrench and a helper for the fittings at the bottom of the barrel. Wearing a glove to protect your hands, apply enough silicone to completely cover the conduit lock nuts inside the barrel. This will prevent leaking. You may need to remove and replace this silicone every few years if you start to notice leaks. Use the bungee cord to attach the screen to the top of your barrel. This screen will help to keep out debris and mosquitoes. You can cut off excess screen, but leave enough so that the bungee can hold it in place. Use the hose clamp to attach the overflow hose to the PVC adapter at the top of the barrel. You will need a flathead screwdriver to tighten the hose clamp. Your rain barrel is finished and ready to install.
When looking for a location to install your rain barrel, there are a few things to keep in mind. Where do you want to use the water from your barrel? If you need to use the water for your backyard garden, make sure to install the rain barrel close by. Water's heavy, and you don't want to carry it too far if you don't have to. There will probably be some splashback as water hits the screen on top of your rain barrel. Try to keep it away from windows and doors, where wooden frames may rot if kept wet. You'll want to elevate your rain barrel off of the ground using pavers, cinder blocks, or a built platform of some kind. This will help you get more water pressure and allow you to fit a watering can or bucket underneath the hose bib. If you have downspouts, you can install the rain barrel under the downspout. Simply cut the downspout above the rain barrel and reinstall the curved part of the downspout so that it directs water into the rain barrel. If you do not have a downspout, take a look around your house looking for areas where a lot of water flows off the roof. You can find these areas by observing them during rain or by looking for signs of erosion on the ground underneath your eaves. A rain chain is an easy way to help direct water into your rain barrel if you don't have a downspout. The chain provides surface area for water to cling to as it flows into your barrel. They also make an attractive art piece. Now that you have built and installed your rain barrel, it's ready to use for years to come. Make sure to inspect and maintain your rain barrel throughout the year. Check for leaks and repair as needed. Clean off any debris off the protective screen. The inside of your rain barrel may become dirty with algae or very small debris, like pollen. When needed, empty your rain barrel completely and scrub it out. The information in this video, and more, can be found in Clemson's Rainwater Harvesting for Homeowners manual. The manual includes step-by-step instructions for making your barrel, along with other types of barrels, placement tips, and decoration ideas. If you're interested in installing more stormwater control measures around your property, rain barrels pair excellently with rain gardens. Rain gardens are depressed, landscaped areas that intercept runoff or overflow from your rain barrel and allow it to infiltrate into the soil, removing sediments, excess nutrients, bacteria, and metals. This results in cleaner water reaching our rivers and oceans. Cleaner water for South Carolina.